and then an independent, rights-protecting, democratic Palestinian state for the reasons I mentioned. But I think those who are engaged in this, like Kerry, should be putting that at the forefront of his involvement. Namely, why not ask not just Israel to release Palestinian murderers? Why not ask Abbas to cease incitement? Why not just ask Israel to cease settlements? Why not ask Abbas to turn Palestine into a democratic, rule of law, rights-protecting entity? So what bothers me is not only that there are not direct negotiations in the context that I'm in, but if there was to be an American intermediary, it seems that all the pressure is being put on Israel and very little is being put on the Palestinian Authority. And when I was here the last time, about 2 months ago, and Kerry, in one of his many visits, said, in effect, that, you know, if there would be no peace, then Israel would be at blame for it, and delegitimization would be increasing, and so on. He, in effect, was giving an incentive for the Palestinian Authority not to come to an agreement, because he said in the absence of agreement would mean the isolation of Israel, the absence of an agreement would be the delegitimization of Israel, etc., etc. So not only am I concerned about the fact that there are not direct negotiations, I'm concerned about the nature of the intervention that is taking place under the auspices of the United States. And so in Syria, they led from behind, and with regard to the Israeli-Palestinian process, they're leading in a way that, in my view, will not lead to an authentic Israeli-Palestinian peace, which I think we all would wish for, but with emphasis on the word authentic. That's what both the Israeli and the Palestinian people need, a true peace, not a false and prejudicial one. Thanks very much.